For this observer, the operating heart of the Lehigh Valley Transit Company is best represented by the downtown Allentown Hamilton Street intersections at 6th, 7th, and 8th Street. In the 1940s, an average 38 regularly scheduled cars per hour passed through each of these intersections, roughly a streetcar every 1.5 minutes, not including extra cars, freight cars, and other rail cars that showed up from time to time. The population of Allentown was roughly 100,000 people, a significant number of whom rode transit. Seeing the cars and the traveling public downtown was a sight to behold. The intersection at 6th and Hamilton is important for another reason. 606 Hamilton Street was the home of Salomon Jewelers and noted rail fan Gerhard Salomon, whose video we are watching. This video is a 9-minute preview of the third video compiled from Gerhard's 8,000-foot, 8mm film archive. It seems fitting to start the preview from 6th and Hamilton Street, just below the second floor location of the jewelry store. This brief preview will touch every line active during the 1947 to 1951 period and will illustrate a significant number of the various classes of streetcars in use during LBT's late years. The preview will provide you with the flavor of the new release, the City Lines of the Lehigh Valley Transit Company. Here is a 900 class car at 17th and Chu, next to the fairgrounds, heading for Greenewald's. At one time, there were 39 900 cars. They were purchased in two batches. The first group of 24, ordered in 1917, were equipped with standard Brill trucks. The second group of 15, ordered in 1919, were equipped with Taylor trucks. All the cars were center entrance cars and operated by two-man crews. Beginning in the mid-1920s, the cars were converted to front entrance single-operator cars. The 900 cars were the workhorse cars of the LBT fleet from the early 1920s until the end of service in 1953. The Greenewald's line was particularly notable for its bad track, bad ties, and rough roadbed. Base service on the Greenewald's line was provided by 900 cars. By the 1940s, only those 900 cars with Taylor trucks were permitted to operate regular service on Greenewald's. While the Taylor trucks had a reputation for a hard ride, these trucks were more likely to stay on the track at speeds up to 30 miles an hour, compared to those 900s equipped with Brill trucks. We are riding a 430 series Philadelphia Division local car. The operator is pulling up at the block signal for the Liberty Bell line at Eneyville Junction to wait for an inbound Liberty Bell car from the south. While waiting, we will be joined by a westbound 900 car returning from Liberty High School and South Bethlehem. Cars ran every 20 minutes on the south side route from Allentown and from South Bethlehem and Liberty High School, located at Elizabeth Avenue and Linden Streets. Until February 1932, the tracks on London Street continued beyond the crossover, outbound to Nazareth, PA. Hellertown service ran from Broad and New Streets in Bethlehem, east and south to Hellertown, then returning through South Bethlehem to 3rd and New Streets, finally north to Broad and New to complete the trip. Service ran every 15 minutes and was generally provided by 900 series cars, although extra service could be offered by any type of car. An ex-Dayton and Troy 1929 lightweight running Easton Limited service through Bethlehem. An ex-CL&E 1930 Cincinnati Car Company lightweight, now Liberty Bell 1000, running a rare fan trip from Allentown to Bethlehem. Acquired as part of the 1938-1939 modernization program, the 14-car 410 series were built by Kuhlman in 1923. These cars originally ran on the Ohio Valley Electric Railway. When they entered service on the LVT, the cars were assigned to the Northampton line, where they provided the base service. This 214 series car was one of 10 ordered by Easton Transit Company in 1916. They were the last new cars purchased by ETC. The 214 series shared Easton Limited responsibility with the four ex-Dayton and Troy lightweights bought for the modernization program. Running alongside Fullerton Avenue, this 900 car is heading for Greenewald's via Allentown's 6th Ward. LVT 961, a 1926 Brill-built ex-Williamsport car running extra and followed by a 950 series car in Bethlehem Allentown service. The 10 1930 Brill-built 950s were the last new cars purchased by Lehigh Valley Transit Company.